Hi, this week I went to the cinema again and saw Kinds of Kindness, the second film we've seen this year from Yorgos Lanthimos. As a result of Poor Things having a very extensive post-production period with huge numbers of visual effects, it meant that that film was delayed very heavily, so he was able to shoot Kinds of Kindness in the meantime and release it for this summer. It's a three-part anthology film running almost 3 hours, telling three stories of characters fulfilling Lanthimos's standard concepts of being trapped in absurd systems or societies with bizarre and arcane rules. In our first story, we see a man who is entirely controlled by his boss, even his working habits, the books he reads, his eating, his daily menus, even the time he gets up in the morning, even at weekends, is all governed by his boss. When his boss gives him the task of killing someone in a car accident, he never certainly declines, even though the person to be killed has already given their consent. But when he continues to refuse, he has to drop out of the business and discovers his life falling apart. In the second story, it's about a man who his marine biologist wife has gone missing when she suddenly returns, having been found lost at sea. It's discovered that he, or he finds rather, that she's not quite the same woman as he remembered. Her likes and dislikes appear to be totally different. Her clothes don't fit properly anymore. Her shoes don't fit. And there's something strange about her personality he can't quite define. As he becomes consumed by his own belief that she's been in some way changed or replaced, she tries desperately to convince him otherwise. The third story is about two members of a cult obsessed with keeping the body's water pure, that can only be done with special water blessed by their leader and containing his tears. They're looking for someone who's capable of resurrecting the dead and conduct a series of ongoing tests with volunteers. However, when one of the members repeatedly visits her old family, whom she's had to separate from, she's excommunicated from the cult and tries to get back in their good graces by tracking down the healer and bringing them back into the fold. The characters in all three stories are played by the same rotating cast: Jesse Plemons, Emma Stone, Hong Chow, Willem Dafoe, Joe Alwyn. And there are some very good performances here. Emma Stone typically is very strong. This is her third film with Lanthimos, and he really seems to have found his muse. She doesn't seem to have any kind of reluctance to take on these very strange characters, dealing with bizarre societies and bizarre behavior. And Plemons again has a quiet soulfulness, in particular in the first story, where he's completely bewildered by how his life completely disintegrates after being thrown out of heaven. This godlike being who controls his every move and showers him with gifts, and who then completely denies him when he refuses to kill someone. It's almost a biblical style story. The second I found harder to get a handle on, the idea of it being a body snatcher type story, but possibly the main character's delusion, and it never really settles down, and the ending I thought wasn't quite there. It suggests maybe it was a delusion, maybe it was real, but it goes, I think, too far in odd directions for it to work coherently. The final story I thought was probably the best. It very much adheres to Lanthimos's ideas of these enclosed societies with bizarre rules that are treated by the film as being very deadpan, very flat and affectless. And Stone takes the lead in that story. She's terrific. Margaret Qualley has a recurring, well, not a recurring role, but has minor roles throughout. And there is a thread connecting all three stories of the presence of an unnamed minor character, the person who's killed in the first story, who is the pilot of the helicopter who found the missing woman in the second, and who appears at the end of the third, in fact has a post-credit scene explaining the title of the third story. It's a return to Lanthimos's earlier stranger work, that, as I say, that strange, affectless, deadpan exploration of bizarre worlds, like not The Favourite, The Lobster, or not Alps, Dogtooth. I don't think I've seen Alps yet. I'm looking forward to that. And general found this not great, but certainly good, and certainly worth recommending if you have the time for it.